Let's look at intersection today. Okay, so intersection. This is the first part of this chapter. If I wanted to represent the intersection between A, set A and set B, you can use this symbol to represent it. This means that A intersect B, the intersection between set A and set B. If you have a two set like this, A and B, where is the region representing A intersect B? A intersect B is a region that these two sets overlap each other. The common region for this A and B. So it will be here. So this part is inside A. At the same time, this part is inside B as well. So this is the intersection between set A and set B. Okay, let me give you an example. Let's say we have a universal set. All the students, of Form 4 today. So B student who like to play B. Okay, we use badminton. Badminton. Okay, we just give one more set. F student who like to play football. So if the Venn diagram given to you is like this, so this B, F, and we have a universal set over here. Okay, let's say this is 5, and this is 10, this is 15, and here is 6. Okay, what does this Venn diagram tell us? Look at this one first. We look at this one, 10. It means that there are 10 students. They only like to play badminton. So do you notice that this 10, it's inside the badminton, but it's not inside the football, right? It's not inside this set F. So these 10 students, they like badminton only. Okay, how about this? Okay, right here. How about this 15? This 15 is inside F, but it's outside of B. So it means that this 15 student, they only like to play football. Okay, so how about this? 5. The 5 is inside the set B. At the same time, the 5 is inside the set F as well. Means that this 5 student, they like badminton, and they also like football. Normally, if you see this intersection, alright, you will always see the word and. Okay, so how about this 6 student? The 6 student is inside this universal set. It means that these 6 students are also from Form 4 Chadet. But these 6 students, they don't like football and they don't like badminton either. So football, don't like, they don't like to play football. Badminton, they don't like to play badminton either. Okay, so how about if we have a Venn diagram which we have three circles. Okay, let's try three circles. Let me draw first. A, B, C. Okay, so this is universal set. So if I wanted to shade the region for A in the set B, so since that the questions only talk about A and B, we just ignore the C. So if I want you to shade the regions of A in the set B, then it will be here. The overlapping area between set A and set B here. Okay. So how about if I ask you to shade the region of B in the set C? I want to find the intersections of set B and set C. Since that the questions only talk about B and C, we just ignore about A. So we are looking for the overlapping area of set B and set C will be here. Okay, let's try. How about we look for the intersection part between three sets? So now about how about if I ask you to shade the region, the intersection between set A, set B, and set C. So I am looking for the region which is inside A and inside B and also inside C. Okay, you look at this diagram. Which part? They are actually inside these three sets. Means that the overlapping area between among these three sets. Which one? Here. This is the region for A in the set B in the set C. Okay, so now let's try some questions. Okay, let's look at some of my intuition note. So this one I told you just now, that should be no problem, right? Okay, so if A is inside set B, so A is a subset of B, the overlapping area between A and B, A in the set B will be here. Okay, so how about this? So you will notice that A and B, they do not overlap each other. In this case, if I ask you to find A in the set B, that will be empty set. They don't have any overlapping area. Okay, this one I told you just now should be okay. Okay, this is complement. We look at it later. Okay, now look at this example number one. So you can draw a Venn diagram first if you want. If you don't want, you also can get the answer easily. List the element of P in the set Q. Means that we are looking for the number, the element, which is inside set P and also inside the set Q. So 3 is not inside here, so we cannot write 3. 4, yes, set Q has 4 as the element, set P has 4 as the element also. So we can take 4. 5, okay, you have 5 here and 5 here. Okay, let me use highlight. So you have 4 and 4, you have 5 and 5. 7 also. So the intersection between set P and set Q will be 4, 5, and 7. Okay, so how about Q and R? Q and R. So now we have to focus on this Q and set Q and also set R, these two. Okay, so normally if you have a 4 element and 3 element, we look at the set which has less element. So you don't have to think many times. For example, if you look at this set, you have to think this way. 4 is not inside here. 5 is not inside here. 7 is not inside here. 8, okay? 8 is the intersection between Q and R. You have to think four times, right? So if you go this way, if you go this way, so it will be faster. Okay. 6 is not inside here, so we cannot write the, we cannot write the 6. 8 is not in, yes, 8 is inside. 9 is not inside. You only need to think 3 times, right? So when we are looking for the intersection between two sets, we want to list out the element. We normally we take the set which has less element to think to find the intersection, to find the element which is inside that two set. Okay, I hope that you understand. Okay, so now Q in the set R, Q and R will be 8. Okay, now let's try one more. P and R, so will be these two. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4 elements. Here you have 3. So I will use this one to find their intersection. 6 is not inside here, so we cannot write the 6. 8 is not inside. Q not inside either. They don't have any intersection part. So here will be empty set. If you don't want to write this, okay, let me write. Write nicer. This is empty set. If you don't want to use this symbol, you also can use this symbol. So if you want to draw a Venn diagram, let me draw for you. Okay, when we want to draw a Venn diagram, right? So we need to consider whether these three sets, they overlap each other or not. Okay, so I look at P and Q first. P and Q. So now I am trying to look, choose the last element one. Try to think whether these three sets overlap each other or not. So 6 is not inside here, not inside here. 8 is inside here, but it's not inside here. So 9 is not inside here, right? Okay, so I know that this Q and R, they are overlapping each other. Okay, this is Q and this is R. Okay, now we go to P. So P and Q, they have intersection, right? So which is 4, 5, and 7. 4, 5, 7. So when I draw a Venn diagram, it will be like this. So this is P. So if I want to fill in the element, normally we start from inside. Okay, so B intersection Q will be 4. Remember to put a dot. 5 and 7. So how about Q and R? Q and R is 8. Remember put a dot. Okay, now I go back to Q. So Q, I have 4, 5, 7, 8. Here is we don't have anything, right? So it's better I use another Venn diagram for you. Okay, then it's okay. Let me fill in all the elements first. So Q, we go to R, we have 6, 8, okay, remember put a dot, 9. So P, we have 3, 4, 5, 7, 3, 4, 5, 7, and Q, 4, 5, 7, 8, right? So but this Venn diagram is not, it's not really good because you have a region which is empty, right? So it's better we use another Venn diagram. Okay, how about we draw this one? Let's try. So this is P. This is P. Okay, let me use color. Okay, let me use the color so easier for you to see. Now this whole set is Q. Whole set is Q. And now we have R here. Okay, let me fill in the element between Q and R, the intersection part. Q and R will be 8 here. And P and Q, P and Q will be 4, 5, 7. 4, 5, 7. Okay, then P we have another 3 here. R we have 6 and 9. 6 and 9. Okay, let me check again, correct or not. 6, 8, 9. Okay, Q we have Okay, P, we have 3, 4, 5, 7. Okay, correct. Okay, so let's proceed to... so this one should be okay. This one, you just need to think a little bit, then you draw a Venn diagram, right? So when you want to draw a Venn diagram, you need to consider whether they have the overlapping area or not. Okay, so this one, I just skip it. Okay, let's try this one. Universal set is this. Okay, this symbol you have to be careful. So sometimes it's only this. It means that it's greater than, not included that value here. Okay, so this means that the universal set is all integers and it's from 1 until 25. And P is an odd number and Q is a prime number and R is a multiple of 5. Okay. So we need to list the element for this following intersections. So it's better we list out all the element for this four set first. Okay, universal set is 1 under 25, right? Okay, we have a lot, it's okay, we don't have to list out all. Okay, 24. 25. Okay, so P. Yeah, let me write over here. P. Odd number. So odd number. Okay, remember this. All the set under discussed under the universal set, right? Their element must be taken from the universal set. If the universal set does not have that element, we cannot write the element here. So P is 1, 3, 2, 0. Okay, odd number, right? So this is 3, 2, 3, 2. Okay, let me check it out or not. Okay, so correct. So let's proceed to Q, prime number. Okay, I'll write Q over here. Prime number. So prime number is also all the prime number are odd number except 1. So 2 is only even and also prime. So we have 2 and 3, 5, 7, 9, oh no, 9 is not a prime number because 9 can be divided by 3, right? Prime number means that that number only has two factors, 1 and itself. Okay, so 9 is not prime number. 11, 13, 17, 19, 23. Okay, these are the elements for set Q. Go to the last one, multiple of 5. Okay, right over here. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. 20, 25. Okay. So these are the... Can I write 30, 35, 40? No, because the universal set until 25 only. Still remember just now what I told you? All this element must be taken from this universal set. Okay. Now we look at P intersection R. So still remember just now, I told you that when you want to find the intersection, right? You want to list out the element for the intersection of two sets. We look at the set which has less element. Okay, so if you go this way, right, you have to think many times because you have many elements here. So how about we go this way? 5 inside here. Okay, we can take the 5. 10, it's not inside here. 15, yes, 15. 20, no, it's not inside here. 25, yes. Okay. So P intercept R will be 5, 15, and 25. Okay. Okay, let's try P and Q. P and Q. The intersection between P and Q. So this we have a large element, so I will take this one to find the intersection. Okay, 2 is not inside here, right? So we cannot take 2. 3, yes. 3, yes, inside. 5, yes, inside here. 7, yes. Okay, so these are okay. The rest will be all yes. 11, we have 11. 13, yes. 17, yes. 19. 23. Okay, so the intersection between P and Q will be 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23. Okay, let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one, right? Any mistake here? Yes, correct. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Okay, correct. Okay, so this one I think it should be no problem, right? You just look at this two set. Okay, now we go to P intersect Q intersect R. So when we come to three set, sometimes the student will start to feel hard to determine the element or confusing. So now we have Q, we have P, we have R. So we have a lot of element to be considered, right? So choose the one which has less element. So we take this one. We go one by one. So 5 is inside here. Inside here also, okay. 5 is the intersection between Q, R, and P. So how about 10? 10 is not inside here. Cannot. 15. 15 is inside here, but it's not inside Q. So we cannot take 15. How about 20? No. How about 25? No. So we only have one element for the intersection between among these three sets, which is 5. Okay? Okay, let's try this one. One more question. Same thing, we list out the element for every set first. Universal set. Okay, be careful of this sign. 20 is not included. Integer will be 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, dot dot dot. We have 18 until 19. So 20 is not included because you see the symbol here. Less than 20. Okay, now we go to P. Find multiples of 2. So remember, all the elements here must come from universal set. Okay, so now we go to Q. Prime number. So 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. Okay, let me check and see correct or not my answers. Okay, so let's try last one. Okay, this one you have to be more careful. It will be some student might make mistake here. Okay, the factors of 16, right? So 16, okay, now we try to think about the factors. 1 times 16. 2 times 8, then 4 times 4. Okay, so the factor will be 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16, right? But we cannot write the 1. We cannot include the 1 here. Why? Because the universal set does not have 1. So we cannot write 1. This element, all this element must be taken from this universal set. So we can write 2, okay, so 4, okay, 8, okay, and 16, okay. So be careful for this one. Okay, now we need to draw a Venn diagram to represent the element, to represent this 4 set, universal set, set P, set Q, and set R. So we need to plan, we need to look at their overlapping area. We need to plan how to draw the Venn diagram. Okay, so you will notice that 2, 4, 8, 16 is inside this P, right? 2, 4, 8, 16. So in the beginning, we might draw this way. So it's inside. Let's say it's inside here. Oh. Inside. So when you draw the Venn diagram, use pencil. Easier for you to erase if you make any mistake. So this is R, this is R, this is P, right? So 2, 4, 8, 16 is all inside here. 2, 4, 8, 16. And remember to put a dot. Okay. So now we look at Q. P and Q, any intersection, we have 2. So, okay, no more intersection part. We can draw this way. Okay, so Q, we have 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. So now we have 2, right? So, write 3. The 3 you cannot put here. Why? Because the 3 is not inside set P. 5 is not inside here and not inside here either. So the 5 we have to take put outside here. 5, 7, 11. Oh, I need to draw. I need to write very small. Not enough space. Okay, let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, correct. But you will notice that if you draw this way, oh, I haven't filled in all the elements. I still need to fill in the element for P. So we have 2, 4, 6. Okay, 6 then. 2, 4, 6. 6 will be outside. 2, 4, 6. And 8. Okay, then. 12, 14, 16, 18. Okay, let me check again. Correct, not E or let's see. Gotcha. Okay, great. So you notice that this you have an empty space here. So we try to avoid this type of empty space. So what we can modify this. Venn diagram is we can do this way, draw a nicer Venn diagram. Okay, let me use another color. Okay, so and then. We have another Q over here. Oh. So this is Q. And we have R. And also last one is P. Okay, so now we try to fill in the element. 2. So R is 4, 8, 16, 4, 8, 16, correct, not, oh, super, okay, correct, So P we have 6, we have 12, and then 14, and the last one is 18. Okay, how about Q? We have 5, 3, 7, 13, 17, 11, 19. Okay. So if you draw this way, then you don't have any empty space. Okay. So after you draw this Venn diagram for A, you can list out all the elements easily. Okay, that's right. So I will use this one. P intersection R, the overlapping area between P and R. So which is this? Here, right? So the element will be 2, 4, 8, and 16. Okay. How about Q intersect R? The overlapping area between Q and R. This is here. 2. Right? The 2 is inside Q and 2 is inside R also. How about this? The intersection between the intersection among P, Q, and R means that this element inside P, inside Q, and also inside R. Okay, so that's only one element, right? So the 2 is inside Q, is inside R, is inside P. Oh, my mouse has some problem for me. Okay. Now we cannot write 4. Why? The 4 is inside R, is inside P, but the 4 is not. Oh, some problem on my computer. Let me find out the problem. Okay, my computer has some problem, so I think I need to stop here. Okay, so hopefully you understand better after watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye bye.